The topic of this video is Industrial HiVision version 7. As the name suggests, this is a major new release of Industrial HiVision, and it's packed full of new features. It's taken almost 1 year to create this software, so as you can imagine, the contents are impressive. Rather than examining every new feature, this video will concentrate on major new functions in the software. Whenever we make a new version of Industrial HiVision, we focus on a specific aspect of the software. This time, we decided to focus on larger networks. For many years, Industrial HiVision has been great for managing medium-sized networks, but industrial networks are increasing in size. In a previous version, we introduced the hierarchical domain and subdomain principle. Since then, our users have suggested other functionality which would facilitate the commissioning and management of large networks. This is what we've implemented in version 7. This video is divided into three sections. We'll start by looking at typical installation functionality, in other words, functions for deploying networks. Then we'll move on to a very important section, functionality for operation of a network. This is where we focus the majority of our development effort. There are only a couple of functions which we will look at, but these functions are immensely valuable. Finally, I'll describe a new change to the licensing mechanism. So let's jump into the installation functionality. As I mentioned, this version of Industrial HiVision is targeted at the management of large networks. One of the issues with large networks is how to get the network devices into Industrial HiVision. Before this version, there were two methods to do it. The first was to enter the devices manually. Clearly, this is impractical on a large network. The second method to discover devices was to scan the network. You can enter an address scan range, and Industrial HiVision will scan every address in that range to discover and identify network devices. That works well on smaller networks. On larger networks, it's less practical. For example, let's say that a network is using a Class B address range. A Class B network supports approximately 65,000 IP addresses. That's a lot of addresses to scan. In an alternative scenario, a company could have many smaller networks, but only have a few devices in each network. This would also result in excessive scanning for the number of devices which need to be found. In version 7, we've created a function which allows devices to be imported into Industrial HiVision from a list. The list is a text file or a CSV file, which contains the IP addresses of the devices which should be supervised. This list is imported into Industrial HiVision, which then scans just the addresses in the list. This has several advantages. First of all, there is no scanning of address ranges. So the time-consuming scans of large address ranges are no longer necessary. Secondly, a disadvantage with scanning is that it discovers everything. Any device which has an IP address and responds to a ping will appear inside Industrial HiVision. Often, that's not what the network administrator wants. It then becomes necessary to delete the unwanted devices. Importing from a list avoids this problem, leaving you with exactly the devices you want to supervise. Another new feature is the progress bar. Today, Industrial HiVision will scan an address range and determine whether a device is attached to the network. In other words, if a device responds to a ping, it will be added to Industrial HiVision. So when Industrial HiVision runs a scan, every available device is shown in the topology map. A progress bar shows the progress of the scan. Once the scan is completed, Industrial HiVision starts a second process where it tries to identify the make and model of each device. Most network devices will respond to SNMP, so Industrial HiVision downloads SNMP variables from each device in order to identify them. This is a time-consuming process, especially on large networks. It was purposefully designed to be time-consuming, to avoid overloading the network with data traffic. So the speed of the process has deliberately been throttled back. Of course, on large networks with many devices, it's not clear when the identification process will be finished. Today, the network administrator must constantly scroll down the screen to see if all devices have been identified. So now we've introduced a second progress bar. This indicates what percentage of devices has already been discovered and consequently provides an estimation of how much time is still required to complete the process. Now let's consider the preferences menu. Industrial HiVision is very configurable. It's possible to change so many aspects of how the program looks and behaves. Today, you can install Industrial HiVision and customize it to meet your requirements. However, if you install another copy of Industrial HiVision, you have to start again with the customization. Typically, large networks will use the domain and subdomain hierarchy. This involves multiple instances of Industrial HiVision. Each instance will need to be customized individually. So we've introduced an option to export the customized preferences to a file. This preferences file can then be imported into another instance of Industrial HiVision, for example, a subdomain instance. Now the appearance and behavior of the domain and subdomain are the same. This results in a consistent look and feel across the entire network. The Security tab was first introduced in version 6 of Industrial HiVision. The response from users was very positive. The purpose of the Security tab is to identify unsecure network infrastructure devices. As an example, switches with unsecure protocols like Telnet or HTTP enabled, or devices which are still using the default password, or firewalls which are configured to allow all data traffic through. Even before today, the Security tab provided a very good overview of the security status of a network. So we decided to further extend the overview. We added two parameters. The first is SNTP, or in the case of firewalls, NTP. That might seem like a strange choice. Why should a time protocol be considered relevant to security? Simply because all log files should use coordinated timestamps. Only then does the information in the log files become meaningful. In many cases, this is a part of regulatory compliance and is therefore compulsory. The other security function we now check is restricted management access. The concept behind restricted management access is to allow access to network devices management interface only from specified IP addresses. Typically, only the network management station would be allowed to connect to the network devices. Access from other PCs would be denied. This is a valuable additional layer of security and is highly recommended. Now, an interesting topic. Think of a large network. Are all the infrastructure devices from Hirschmann or Garrettcom? This is very unlikely. Usually, large networks consist of equipment from multiple manufacturers. MultiConfig, which allows many devices to be configured simultaneously, is one of the most valuable functions in Industrial HiVision. Until today, MultiConfig could only be used with our own devices. We've now opened MultiConfig so it can be used with any SNMP-enabled third-party device. This includes not only network infrastructure devices like switches or access points, but also end devices. The development of this function is a complex task. For this reason, we decided to implement it in two stages. The first stage is complete and included in version 7. MultiConfig can now be used on third-party devices to configure standardized parameters. For example, MIB2 parameters or spanning tree. In the next version of Industrial HiVision, we will implement Stage 2. This will enable MultiConfig to be used together with private MIBs. In practice, this means that MultiConfig will be used to configure parameters which are proprietary to a specific manufacturer. That brings us to the end of the installation part. Now let's take a look at operation. There are only two major new functions, but both these functions greatly facilitate the day-to-day management of large networks. The first new function is the network dashboard. In large networks, it's a challenge for the network administrator to know the status of all components. Although Industrial HiVision can provide that information in great detail, what is required is a concise summary. The purpose of the network dashboard is to provide, at a glance, the status of the network. Typically, a dashboard would be displayed on a large screen or projected onto a wall. Periodically, the network administrator can check the dashboard and will immediately be informed about any errors or warnings in the network. It's clear that no two networks are identical, and therefore there is no one-size-fits-all dashboard suitable for all networks. Consequently, the dashboard must be highly configurable. So we've based the dashboard around widgets. A widget is a graphical display of the status of a specific network parameter. We have a device summary widget. This widget displays how many devices in the network are okay, how many have a warning status, and how many have an error status. Arrows within the widget indicate whether the numbers are increasing or decreasing. Another widget provides the same information, but for links. The events widget shows the number of unacknowledged warnings and error events. The security widget shows the number of vulnerable network infrastructure devices. It displays how many rogue devices are attached to the network. It also shows how many devices are running configurations which are different to their reference configuration. There's a widget to display bandwidth utilization for a link in both directions. Another widget shows the 10 devices with the slowest response times across a network. This widget automatically selects the worst top 10 devices. Of course, it's also possible to define which devices should be monitored for response times. So if there are any areas in the network which are a cause for concern, this is a perfect widget to see what's going on. To give the network administrator the greatest flexibility regarding what should be displayed, there's a numeric value widget. This allows any numeric value to be displayed for multiple devices. Typical uses would include device temperature or number of bad packets. To maximize the available information, it's possible to create multiple dashboards and then switch between them at predefined intervals. This gives a kind of slideshow effect. Although other network management systems also offer dashboards, they are limited to displaying standard information. Our network dashboard has the big advantage that it's an inherent part of Industrial HiVision and can therefore display parameters which are specific to Hirschmann devices. It can also be configured using drag and drop from directly within Industrial HiVision. It's difficult to do justice to the network dashboard just by talking about it. You really need to try it for yourself to appreciate the powerful functionality it offers. The second new function is the scheduled configuration backup. Network infrastructure devices can fail, so it's important to have copies of the configuration files of all devices. This can, of course, be done manually, but a common requirement of customers with large networks is to have a mechanism which can automatically back up the configuration files of the network devices at predefined intervals. It's now possible to do exactly this. The administrator can define which devices will be backed up and how often. There's an option either to overwrite the previously stored backup file or to create a new file each time the configuration is backed up. That's the end of the network operations section of this video. As I previously described, there are only two major new functions, but both these new functions will greatly reduce the workload of the network administrator. Now we'll cover some information about licensing. Version 7 of Industrial HiVision includes a promotion license. The license is intended to allow potential customers to evaluate the functionality offered by Industrial HiVision over a longer period of time. This license is provided free of charge. Very importantly, this license has no time limit. It will never expire. The promotion license will support a maximum of 16 nodes. This means that up to 16 devices can be configured or supervised simultaneously. The software supports every function offered by the standard Industrial HiVision license. This is not a light version of Industrial HiVision. There's only one exception. The promotion license does not support subdomains. Only one 16-node license can be used per installation. Also, the promotion license cannot be used in conjunction with a paid license. If a paid license is installed, the promotion license becomes invalid. To get the promotion license, you just need to follow the same procedure as for a paid license. Download and install Industrial HiVision. Make a note of the hardware key. Go to the license website at www.hivision.de. Select the license menu and follow the instructions. The site also includes a video which walks through the installation and licensing process. That brings us to the end of this video. What we've seen are some powerful new features offered in Industrial HiVision version 7. These features were developed with large networks in mind, but will save time and effort for administrators of any size of network. To try these features for yourself, just download Industrial HiVision from www.hivision.de. The software will run for 30 days with no license, and the evaluation period can be extended indefinitely using the 16-node promotion license. I hope you've enjoyed learning about these new features, and thank you for watching.